this time, we're going to have our play director, embassy, playwriter, producer,
novelist,
author, attorney,
amen.
English major. She's single. Virtuous woman. Lord, open your eyes that you might see. Embassy Susbury. Praise the Lord.
I do want to let you know that you should probably not linger in the aisles, in any three of the aisles.
Amen.
And I pray that you enjoy the play and that you have fun and that you're blessed watching.
Amen. Marley was dead. There's no doubt about it. His register was signed by a minister, a clerk of Cook County, an undertaker, and a witness, Scrooge. Scrooge signed it. And Scrooge's name was good for whatever he put his hands to. Evidently, there's no getting around it. Marley was dead. Did Scrooge know Marley was dead? Mm. Of course. Mm. Could it be any other way? He was his administrator, his assigned, his legatee, his friend, and his sole mourner. Mm. And not even Scrooge was so dreadfully cut up by the event. No, he was just so sad he lost a good business partner. Anyway, Marley was dead. But this has to be distinctively understood, or else nothing good can come from the story I'm about to relate. Scrooge never painted out Marley's old name. Oh no. There it stood for years. Scrooge and Marley. Sometimes people in this business would call Scrooge Scrooge, and sometimes they would call him Marley. He answered to both. It didn't matter to him. And so, once upon a time, there was a Christmas Carol.
Alright, I'll go check myself.
Okay,
all right,
bye.
See ya. Merry Christmas, Uncle. God bless you.
Bah, humbug.
Bah, humbug? I'm sure you don't mean
that. Yep, yes I do. Merry Christmas. It's Christmas time to you, but for a time for paying bills with no money.
Well, if that's the case, why are you so dreary? So morose, you're rich enough.
Humbug, I tell you, humbug.
Don't be like that, Uncle.
What else can I be when I live in a world of such fools as this? Mm. Merry Christmas. What's Christmas time to you, but a time for paying bills with no money? You find yourself an hour richer, but not a day, an hour older, but not a day richer. If I had my way, every idiot who goes around with Christmas on his lips, he'd be baking the oven with his own hand and a steak of holly in his heart, he should.
Uncle!
Nephew! Keep Christmas in your way, and I'll keep it in mine.
Keep it? You don't need to keep it yourself!
Then leave it alone, then. Much good it may do you, much good it has ever done you. Mm.
There are many wonderful things about Christmas. It's the only time I know when men and women alike think freely of each other. And it's also the only time that I know when God sent his only son just for us. And even though it has not put a single penny in my pocket, I stand by it and bless it!
One more sound from you, you'll be spending your Christmas looking for a new job!
Come on, don't be like that. Come see me, get married tomorrow.
I'll see you in first.
Don't say say that, Uncle. Why? Why won't you come see if you're married tomorrow?
Why is that silly girl getting married anyway?
Because she fell in love.
Fell in love. Humbug, I tell you, humbug.
No, I won't leave until you tell me why.
I don't do weddings, and I certainly don't do church and God.
You know, Uncle, you're getting pretty old yourself. You might be going to meet him soon.
I'll take care of that the day I die.
No one knows the day of their death. It could be today, or it could be tomorrow. Look, I have a song for you. I wanted you to hear it so you would understand how I feel about this.
Jesus said, here I stand, won't you please let me in?
And
he said, I will, tomorrow. Jesus said, I am he who supplies all your needs. And you said, I will.
Nothing to you. I'm sorry to find you so resolute. And he, I'm sorry, I just can't talk right now.
Door's that way.
You know what, Uncle? I'm sorry to find you so resolute in keeping this Christmas funk. But I have made my trial and honest to Christmas, and I shall keep my Christmas humor to the last. So Merry Christmas!
Don't let the door hit you on the way out.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
And a Happy New Year!
Hey, hey. Merry Christmas. I suppose you believe in Easter Bunny too, huh?
Marley and Scrooge. Hello, sir. Do I have the pleasure of addressing Mr. Marley or Mr. Scrooge?
Marley's been dead these past 7 years. He died 7 years ago this very day.
I'm sorry to hear that. Well, as you know, it's the festive time of the year, and we are trying to collect money for the poor, and it's more than desirable that we give to those who are in need. We have thousands of people who are in need of the just basic necessities, and we have hundreds of thousands of more who are in need of basic common goods, sir. So you can find it in your heart, sir. Just
are there no prisons?
Well, yes, there are plenty of prisons.
Welfare, does that still exist?
It does.
McDonald's, they still hiring?
They are.
Soup kitchens, they still around?
They are.
Yes, sir. They're pretty busy this time of year.
Very well then, I thought something had happened to those things. I'm glad to see they're all still around.
A few of us are endeavoring to start a fund to buy the poor some meat and drink and a means of warmth. I mean, come on, places like soup kitchens don't run off the air, you know. It's Christmas time, Mr. Scrooge. Time for giving. How much shall I put you down for, sir?
You put me down for a big fat nothing.
You mean you wish to remain anonymous?
I wish to be left alone. Since you ask what I wish, I don't make myself merry at Christmas. I can't afford to make lazy people merry either. Therefore, I pay my taxes. I support the establishments mentioned. If people are not well off, then they must go there.
Well, now those establishments don't provide for everything. And prison is not a good choice when you consider the fact that most people would rather die first than be that hungry that they have to go to prison.
If they'd rather die, then they better do so and decrease the surplus in population. Now, have a good day. Quickly!
Merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay.
I suppose you want the whole day off tomorrow, huh?
It's convenient, sir.
It's not convenient. It's not fair. Pay a man for no work. If I were to take money from you, you'd be annoyed, right?
Yeah.
And to think you want me to pay you.
Christmas is only once a year, though, sir.
That's a poor excuse for picking a man's pocket every 25th day of December. You make sure you're here early tomorrow.
I will. I promise, sir.
Yeah, you better.
Yeah.
And sin, and you dismiss our relationship over indigestion, you idiot.
I don't understand. Why are you here? Why are the chains?
These are the chains I forged in life. When I disobeyed God, and I did it my own way, link by link, yard by yard. I put it on my own free will, and against my own free will, I will for eternity. Oh. But Ebenezer, you've been around 7 years longer than I have. Your chains are huge, Ebenezer. Yours are huge.
Huge. I suppose you didn't get to heaven.
What does it profit a man to gain the whole world, but to lose his soul? Ebenezer, it's all about Jesus.
Yes.
Peace is only through Jesus, Ebenezer. Redemption is through Jesus. Salvation is through Jesus, Ebenezer.
Jesus.
It's the only way.
Jesus. Life's about making money.
You fool. You fool. To listen to your fear and your doubt. I've come here to warn you tonight. I hope y'all don't see my tracks. I come here to warn you tonight that you have yet a chance and a hope to avoid my fate. your nephew, for all these years have been praying for you, and as a response, God has allowed me to come to warn you. You must listen, Ebenezer.
Well, you were always a good friend to me.
Ebenezer, tonight you will be visited by three angels.
That's the chance of hope you mentioned earlier?
That's your only chance. Your only hope.
I think I'd rather not. Humbug with you. Humbug, I tell you.
Ebenezer! This is your only hope. The first angel will be at 1 o'clock.
Couldn't I take them all at once and get it over with?
Shut up, you fool! The second will be at 2.
Yeah.
And the third will be at 3, Ebenezer. At 3. You'll never see me again, Ebenezer.
Wait, perhaps you will.
Perhaps you will, Ebenezer.
No, no, wait.
Boy, stop with my cane. Boy, you foul demon. I'm going to bust you in the head. Don't you know I'm a fighter? Get you down.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas.
Oh, Ebenezer, let's get married in the church, not outside. Think of my hair. It might rain.
You didn't have a tent.
What do you have against church anyways? You're so antsy at the Christmas Eve service, and Christmas Eve service is the best.
Nothing. I just think we make our own luck.
What does that mean?
Just what I said, we make our own luck. I work hard equals I have money. I don't work hard means I don't have money. And I go to church just to go to church.
Are you saying there's no payoff?
Come on, obviously there's a payoff. Who else wouldn't go?
Then what are you saying? God has provided us with everything. That's why we celebrate. God sent his son Jesus down to die for us all.
God's provided me with nothing. I'm the one who went to school, I studied, I worked hard all day. It was me, me, me.
I don't understand.
Look, I'm just so sick of all this Christmas stuff, Christmas excitement. It wouldn't even be exciting for if you had nothing. There would be no reason to get excited about Jesus.
I can't, I won't, I can't marry a man who doesn't love Jesus.
Then maybe we won't get married then. Look, honey. Look, I'm sorry. It just came out like that. You know, I go to church with you every single Sunday.
That's not enough. If you don't love Jesus, then we're not compatible. This is not going to work.
You can't mean that.
Yes, I can. You're bitter. You grew up poor, and now you're taking it out on God. You need to make peace. It's the perfect time for that. Peace on earth, goodwill, church man. It doesn't have to be forever, just right now.
I'm not bitter. I just have my eyes open. Religion is a crutch. I refuse to rely on it.
That's it. This is not going to work. Merry Christmas, Ebony Luke Crew!
Happy Christmas Eve!
Happy Christmas Eve to you! Did you get Christmas Day off, Dad?
I sure did.
All I know is that I'm excited about Christmas tomorrow.
You know what? Me too.
There won't be a lot of presents this year, but you know what?
What?
Christmas isn't about celebrating Jesus' birthday. I mean, Christmas is about celebrating Jesus' birthday.
That's right. You know, there won't be a lot of presents this year, but that don't matter. No, Christmas is about celebrating Jesus' birthday. He's done so much for us that if he never did a thing, it would be too much.
But Dad, if Jesus loves us so much, how come we have so little and evil Mr. Scrooge has so much?
First off, Mr. Scrooge is not evil. And who says he has so much? I mean, he goes home, sits alone, goes to work on the next day of Christmas. That's it. That's not living.
All I know is that I'm excited about Christmas tomorrow. Guess what, Dad? It's Christmas. God bless us, everyone.
Hello? Yeah, I got Kim's medical bills. No, don't say that. God will provide. When you come home tonight, we'll pray together, okay? All right. I love you too. Bye. tomorrow.
Me neither.
I invited Uncle Scrooge.
Why would you do that?
Well, he's old, and he needs Jesus.
But you've been trying to tell him about Jesus for years.
Well, we just can't give up. We're talking about an eternity in heaven or hell here. Not whether or not he wants to go to your house for dinner or not. Speaking of which, you should have heard his whole, "You should celebrate Christmas, it makes you bored," speech.
Well, I feel sorry for him.
It's actually kind of funny, even if he isn't the most pleasant person in the room.
Dad, he has all that money.
Much good doesn't. He's in a prison of his own making. I mean, look at him. He doesn't have Jesus, so he's alone. He's in a big house, so he's even more alone. And on top of that, he doesn't come around his only family, so he's even more alone. He's a hamster in his own, in a hamster wheel, going around and around in circles and not getting anywhere. Come on, let's go.
Over. I came. Make it stop. Make it go away. Just want it to be over.
And so it shall be, player.
Oh. Who are you? You're here to show me the future, right? Look, I'm gonna change, I swear. I don't need to go. That's not gonna be any funny business, is it? But can you say something?
All right.
It's the last
time.
Merry Christmas!
I don't know what you heard. What did you hear?
Oh, I don't know.
Nick, no. I don't know much about him. All I know is he's dead. What?
When did he die? Last night, I believe.
Why? I wonder what happened to him. You know, I thought that guy would never die.
God knows.
What did he do with his money?
I don't know. Left it to his company, I believe. All I know is he didn't leave it to me.
It'll probably be a cheap friend of all. I don't know anyone who'll go.
Well, you know what? If there's food, I'll be there.
Hey, where are you going?
That old man's dead. Better get the goods while you can.
I repent. Lord, I repent. I repent. I'm alive. I'm alive. My things, they're all here. My coat, my hat, my money, it's all here. What day is it? What month is it? I feel like a baby and I don't care. What day is it?
It's Christmas, you idiot.
It's Christmas. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas! It's Christmas! Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas! There you go.
Are you serious?
Yep, there's plenty more where that came from. Come see me tomorrow, right?
Thank you, Mr. Scrooge!
Merry Christmas! I want money for you. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Arrange! You got it. Where are you guys headed?
To your niece's wedding, sir.
Come on, let's go. You don't want to be late. Merry Christmas!
Uncle?
Nephew! I'm so standing with your mouth open, boy. Close it! Oh, listen, God heard your prayers and I heard them too. I'm part of God's family now, nephew. Thanks. Now, don't just stay there. Let's get to her wedding. She wouldn't appreciate us being late now. Let's go.
Uncle, you still know you're in a nightgown, right?
It's all right. It's my presence that counts.
And so, thus ends the tale of Scrooge, who learned that apart from God, you are nothing but dust and ash and headed for hell. But with God, you will experience love, joy, peace, and most of all, eternity in heaven. Thank you, and Merry Christmas.
He loves us because he wanted a family, and he created Adam and Eve, and he put them in a wonderful garden. He told them they could eat of all the trees in the garden except for one, and they blew it. They ate of the forbidden fruit, they disobeyed God, and all of humanity fell from the grace and the glory and the goodness of God. That's when death came in. There was no such thing as death until Adam and Eve disobeyed God. The Bible says, for the wages of disobedience is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. Well, Adam and Eve messed up, but you know what? We serve a God of a second chance. Can you say that, second chance?
Second chance.
That's right. I like the story right there in the storyline. Scrooge, I mean, as bad as he was, as evil as he was, as selfish as he was, God gave him a second chance to get it right. And you know what? God is so good, he'll give you a second chance, and a third chance, and a fourth chance, and a fifth chance. In hope that you will wake up and see Jesus and turn to him. I was so happy that Scrooge did repent. He came to himself. He turned around. And he was saved in the end and given eternal life. You know what? I believe God wants to bring that play and the message of that play and the message of Jesus' birth right here to this service to you and I today. Maybe you're here today and say, God, I need a second chance. I've blown it two or three times. I've blown it four or five times.
Well, I got good news for you today. Jesus will take you back and receive you unto himself if you do like Scrooge did, repent and turn to him. Repent means to do an about face and go back to God.